come on, this can't be happening. Come on. Oh, yeah. You know what time it is now, man. What up, though? It's the livest cloud radio show on the planet, straight from the E-Block Radio, with your boy, the Hood Irish Starring Q Lewis, and my man, Monk Money. You know what it is.
The livest cloud radio show on the planet, E-Block Radio.
Yo, you know what it is, man, the livest cloud radio show on the planet, man, straight from the E-Block Radio's live on your dial right this moment. It's your boy, the Hood Howard Stern, Q Lewis, holding it down from the D to the other D in the Rocky Mountains. Just in case you didn't know, that's from Detroit to Denver, all right? That's D in the Rocky Mountains, dog. So I'm back up in the place to be, holding it down on my own today. My man Monk Money couldn't make it today, so I'm going to hold the whole studio down myself, but you know it's all good. You in good hands, you feel me? So don't forget, it's Social Media Thursday, so if you got social media, make sure you hit me up, all right, on Instagram or on Twitter. That's Hood Howard Stern. Also, if you got Facebook, you can hit us up on the fan page. That's www.facebook.com/eblockradio, all right? So make sure you check us out on social media because we out here everywhere, you know what I'm saying? But, there's a lot been going on since last week, so we got a lot to talk about, a lot to dive into. Also, at the end of the show today, I got a very special musical guest. Got my man Lonzo Starr with his brand new single called Clark Kent. All right, so make sure you check him out also on social media. If you got Instagram, then you hit him up, Lonzo _ Starr with two R's. All right, so it's Starr. So let's make sure you check my man out on social media. We'll be playing his new single at the end of the night. And actually, it is also available on iTunes right now and other media outlets. All right, so iTunes definitely is the one. I know a lot of people download stuff from iTunes, so definitely available there. So shout out to my man Lonzo Starr. We'll be playing this joint tonight. But we got a few things to talk about, so we're going to jump right into it. Don't forget, though, if you're on eblockradio.com right now or if you're listening from the mobile app, you can hit us up, 760-283-4647, and then you can hit that number one key and join the conversation. If you joined us early, probably around 6:50 Eastern Standard Time if you're in Detroit, 4:50 if you're out here in the Rocky Mountains with me, then you might have caught the pregame mix. So we're doing a different format now. So we're doing the pregame mix actually before the show, which makes sense, right? It's pregaming. So we're getting that done before the show. All right, so I did a little mix that I put together myself. I like to actually call the mix that I did today a stripper mix. If you didn't catch it, man, make sure you hit the replay, and then you can hear the stripper mix at the beginning or the pregame mix. All right, and real quick before we get started, I want to give a shout-out to my partners. All right, so you can hear our show rebroadcast on these networks at Blackout Radio. GMS Radio in the UK, Sky 99 FM in Trinidad, and, of course, the New Orleans Talk Network.com. All right, so you can make sure you check us out there, catch the replays on all those places, and make sure you support them as well. It's Blackout Radio, GMS Radio in the UK, Sky 99 FM in Trinidad, and New Orleans Talk Network.com. All right, so make sure you check them out. They've got their own shows as well, but those are my partners in crime right there. So you can check out E-Block Radio on all those formats. And, of course, you can catch all the replays at www.eblockradio.com. All right, so we got everything cleared up out the way. So let's talk a little bit of news, you know. So it's Thursday, and, of course, it's been 7 days since the, you know, since the last time we touched base. But a few things have been going on, man. So I would touch on the Donald Trump thing about what he said about, you know, Black America, but we're going to save that until we get into the actual topic, because that's kind of what we're talking about today. But I think I'll start off a little lighter. All right, so what I want to talk about first is the new law for students with driver's education. All right. So this is something new, just popping off in Illinois, actually. So it's not everywhere currently, but in Illinois. So what it is that in Illinois, it is a law or bill that's been passed to create a law that requires driver's education classes to teach new drivers basically what to do when they get pulled over by the police. Now, this is an interesting concept. I mean, definitely I think it's something that's needed. Because obviously, I think, especially in this day and age, I think it may be a little different between Black and white people, you know, possibly, I'm just saying. That's that could be the case. But I think it is something that's definitely needed. So, like I said, this is a bill that just passed in Illinois. Hasn't actually become a law yet, as far as I know, because this only happened a couple of weeks ago. But it is going to require that driver's education classes teach you how to handle being stopped by the police. Now, this is an interesting concept all in itself. Now, I say that it's interesting because, yeah, it's interesting because you're going to teach kids or, you know, new drivers how to react or what to do when being stopped by the police. But I guess I'm concerned because if we learn all these things, especially in the Black community, you know, I'm sorry, I have to equate this to the Black community all the time because it's the community where I'm from. But if we learn everything supposedly, you know, legally, what I should be doing, what I shouldn't be doing, the ways to handle a police officer, you know, pulling me over, what's going to happen when you follow all those rules, right? And then something like, you know, the Castillo thing happens, or, you know, any other instance you can think of police wrongfully murdering, you know, Black people. So what's going to happen then? So if I've went through driver's education and gotten the legal wherewithal, you know, as far as what I need to do when the police pull me over, and I go through all those tactics and still end up dying, what happens then? Like, is the law enforcement agent or, you know, the police officer actually going to get some type of penalty? And I say that, you know, I say that loosely. I guess that's kind of sarcasm, but in real life, it doesn't happen. Like, police officers don't go to jail for killing people. Like, it doesn't happen. So I'm just trying to see if you bring the law to us, like, you know, so now you've been legally trained on how to be pulled over by the police. Once that happens, though, so I'm performing everything to the T, you know, just like the driver's ed teacher taught me. You know, I'm putting my hands at, you know, whatever time you're supposed to put on your steering wheel. Of course, driver's ed was so long ago. But you what they're going to do is show you how to strategically reach for your wallet, you know what I'm saying? They're going to tell you what not to say. And the thing is though, it's going to be different, though. It's going to be different from Black and white people, though. I know a lot of times I make race an issue in some things that I shouldn't, but I think this is going to be one. So it's going to be quite different, like, because there's some things, no matter what you've learned in driver's education, that you can't do as a Black person being pulled over by the police. I mean, for the first thing, honestly, you can't even ask questions. Like, as a Black person being pulled over, like, you can't even ask questions. You just got to pull over and pray to God that you make it out of the stop. Like, so back in the day, you know, back in my day, you used to get pulled over and you'd be scared that you go get the ticket. You know what I'm saying? Like, you nervous that you about to get the ticket. Now it's like you're nervous because you might die. Like, that's the craziest shit ever. So you're going through driver's ed, you know, you're, what, 16 or whatever. Probably 15, then you're 16, you get your license. So you learn all this stuff. You learn what to say, what not to say, how to grab your wallet, I guess, and where to keep your registration insurance so you don't get shot in the face, you know, that kind of thing, right? So you learn all that shit, and then you're out somewhere, you get pulled over by the police, and you think you're doing the right thing, all this stuff, you know, you think that you're doing right. And something still happens. Like, that's crazy. So what happens then? I think that's my point. So, like, you want to put the law on the side, you know, on the side of the driver's education. But at the end of the day, what law is there putting out, or what rules and regulations are being set forth for the person who's actually pulling you over? See, that's the problem. So we're citizens, and we're learning how to react when being pulled over. But the police officers that are pulling us over don't even know how to react. So, I mean, it's got to happen on both ends. Like, it's not, and believe me, like, the bill being passed in Illinois is a step. I guess it's a step in the right direction, so I can respect that. You know, I'm not mad about that. I can respect that. But at the end of the day, if you're going to school in, I mean, this is Illinois, so if you're in the south side of Chicago, that instructor has to teach you a totally different way than if you were in, you know, what's a suburb of Chicago, Aurora or something, you know, out in the suburbs. But it's got to be different, because at this point, we live in an age where no matter what you've learned or what you've been taught about how to get pulled over, it's frightening. It's frightening. But it's crazy that you can be grown, you know, you can make it to my age and be grown and get pulled over, and you feel like your heart feels like you got 15 bricks in the trunk. You know what I'm saying? It's like you feel like you ride around with guns and drugs, but you're just a legal citizen, like, trying to go to work or something. But you feel like, you know, you start perspiring, your heart beating fast, like you got all kind of illegal shit in the car, and you don't. But that's because the system has been set in a way that it kind of disregards, and I know people try to act like this don't occur, but it disregards black people. Like, it does. Like, there's no way you can act like it doesn't. You know what I'm saying? That's really impossible. Now, of course, it's white people being killed by police too. So don't let me try to take that away from the whole, the bigger picture. But I think we in a worse position. So yeah, the law requirement of, you know, learning how to deal with police when they pull you over is definitely a step in the right direction. But perhaps this is a conversation that we need to have in our household regardless. Like, because this pertains to all drivers. So if you're in driver's ed, you know, you're about to be a beginning driver and you're getting this education, then that's cool too. But I think for us, and when I say us, I mean the black community, I think this is a conversation we got to have in the home. If you got a 19, 20, 21-year-old driver who's been driving for, you know, theoretically 5 years, if they got their driver's license at 16, you know, this is a conversation you still got to have with them. Like, you have to have a clear understanding of what you can and can't do getting pulled over by the police. And that's crazy, though, when you think about it, because I can't guarantee you because I don't know for sure, but I'm pretty sure that this is not a conversation that white parents have to have with their kids. I'm pretty sure. Like, I'm pretty sure they don't have to tell them that, you know, if you get pulled over by, please cooperate so you can come home. I'm willing to bet that that's not a conversation that they have to have. Man, as unfortunate as it is, I mean, it's a conversation that we have to have, because too many black people get pulled over. And, you know, a lot of them don't die. You know, a lot of them don't get murdered. But a lot of them are just, you know, there's been an abuse. There's been an abuse of power. You know what I'm saying? So even though a lot of people get pulled over and don't die, they've been, you know, they've been degraded to a degree. Just like, for instance, you know, real quick, just like the Department of Justice investigation of the Baltimore Police Department. They had a record of like a black lady getting pulled over, and they making a strip, you know, they giving a strip search like on the side of a street, like a main street. That's got to be some kind of violation. I can't imagine if they would make a white woman get out the car and strip naked while they give her a strip search. Like, who does that? Like, it's almost like an assumed guilt as soon as you get pulled over. And that's a bad thing, man. It really is a bad thing. And that's going to kind of lead into the next story that I want to talk about. But shout out to Illinois, you know, for taking that step to try to get things at least moving in the right direction. But let's shoot over to the next story, because this is probably one of the worst stories. And, well, first of all, it's this. All right, so if you're not familiar, I think it was about three days ago, a kid from Newark, that's out in Jersey on the East Coast, apparently, like I say, all the details aren't solid at this point, but apparently a 10-year-old was outside playing with some of his friends. And as he went to go, grab the ball, I think he was playing basketball or something, like he went in the street. So he went to go get the basketball, and when he looked up, there were police officers. Now, police officers, like, in a tactical unit, though. You know, like some, maybe not SWAT team, but in that kind of essence, though. You know, some tactical, like, some supposedly trained motherfuckers, right? So he looked up, and they running down on him with shotguns, or, like, they got guns out. Now, this is a 10-year-old kid out with his friends. So immediately, because, like, I don't know how it is in everybody else's community, but in our community, if somebody running at you with a gun, I think the first instinct is to run, like, no matter what age you are. So he turns and runs, and they chasing him. Like, so they chase a 10-year-old kid down the street, like, with guns drawn. Like, he's a 10-year-old kid. So they get him to a point where I guess either he, they caught him in a corner or something, but they surrounded him. So the, you know, people in the neighborhood ran out to, you know, try to basically save him, because he was in a position where, from where we from, you know, people get killed like that by the police. So they cornered him. The neighbors came out like, hey, you know, it's a kid, like, get out of here, you know, trying to stop him from hurting him or doing anything. So finally they ease up. And while they're trying to, you know, while the community's people are there trying to explain, you know, what's going on, one of the officers say, well, you know, he fits the description of some criminal, right? Now, this is a 10-year-old kid. So the description is a 20-year-old man, right? A 20-year-old man with dreadlocks. This is a 10-year-old kid with a small natural fro. So let me get this straight. You got a tactical unit who supposedly are trained to do these types of jobs, and they mistook a 10-year-old kid for a 20-year-old man with dreads. I don't see how that's possible. You know, I could be wrong. You know, maybe this is the oldest 10-year-old kid I've ever seen. You know, probably not. But so I looked at the pictures just to see, you know, just to kind of, you know, just for shits and giggles. So I look at this picture, and he a husky dude, you know, he's a bigger 10-year-old, but he don't look 20, though. You know, he don't look 20. Let's just get that straight. So they showed the other 20, they showed the dude that's really looking for. He's a big dude, too, with dreadlocks, right, and some facial hair. So I'm trying to see, how did this 10-year-old kid look like a 20-year-old man with facial hair and braids? Like, I just don't even get it. And the reality of it is that, you know, reportedly, like I said, after they kind of sorted out the confusion, like, the police officers just kind of left. Like, you know, all of them left. Like, they didn't apologize for the situation or, you know, try to make sure everything was all right. This little kid was, like, was on the porch, like, was crying hysterically. Like, the video went viral because the lady ended up, she didn't write any of the information down, so she said she needed to document it somehow. So she put it on Facebook, you know what I'm saying, so people could see his reaction. And, like, the kid was, like, terrified. Because you're talking about a 10-year-old kid, though. You know, you're talking about a 10-year-old kid who has been ran down on by police with guns drawn. So I'm going to be honest with you. That kid going to be fucked up. Like, so in the black community, you know, we not real 100 on we not real 100 on like shrinks and shit like that, you know, therapists. But I think this is a situation where for sure, man, dude's gonna need some therapy, because at this point, at 10 years old, dog, if you get ran down by the police with guns drawn, you gonna have a different idea about the police from that point forward. So this dude, I mean, I hate to say it, you know what I'm saying, like me and Coco J was having this conversation last night, but this dude is either gonna be like the ultimate knucklehead, don't give a fuck, you know what I'm saying, or he gonna be Malcolm X. Like, it ain't gonna be no in between. He gonna hit one of the extremes. Like, he either gonna really hate police officers, or he gonna be fucking militant. Like, it ain't gonna be no in between, because you got an experience like that at 10 years old. Like, at 10 years old, I don't want to get chased down by nobody. I don't want to get chased down by my friends with guns out. Like, I'm just saying, he's 10 years old. And just to see his reaction, though, like, I mean, he was hysterical. And how could you blame him, though? Because just think about any 10-year-old that you know right now. I mean, just think about it real quick. Any 10-year-old that you know, I'm just like, could you imagine police officers chasing your 10-year-old son, daughter, cousin, nephew, you know, niece or whatever? A 10-year-old, though, just think about it. Like, 10-year-olds are, at that point, are impressionable beyond anything you can imagine, you know? So, I mean, at this point, we got a 10-year-old who has been ran down by the police. I have to keep saying that, because I think it's blatant disregard by the police after the fact. So, okay, let's give you this. You know, y'all like worse police officers than fucking Barney Fife and shit, right? So y'all like some bumbling idiots. So, okay, so I'll give you that, all right? So you fucked all the way up. You thought a 10-year-old was a 20-year-old. Okay, I'm going to let all that shit go. But now I'm going to say, after you found out you fucked up and you see the situation is terrible, how do you just walk away from that scene, though? Like, how do you just leave? Like, you don't try to console nobody or say, hey, shit, we fucked up. I'm sorry. We did something wrong. I think at some point, if police officers would at least say that, like, damn, we fucked up. You know what I'm saying? We should have did that shit. I think some of the tension would be dropped off. But since police officers can't even fucking do that, like, it's like they can't even admit that they fouled up. Like, that was some foul shit. You chasing a 10-year-old kid. I'm just saying. Well, first of all, I was going to say it was a white kid and shit, you know, it had been totally different. But the reality of it is that he probably wouldn't have been getting chased in the first place. But that's a whole other story. But so they find it okay to run down on kids in the community and then just be like, fuck it, all right. So the lady says, she's like, I'm going to file a report. So my man, one of the arrogant-ass police officers just yelled back at her, like, giving her the address to the municipal court downtown and shit. Like, being funny, basically. Like, well, this here goes the address, go do it. You know, that type of shit. It's just the arrogance of police. Now, that's just the arrogance of white supremacy, though. And please don't let me go down that road, because I go down that road. Because I'm so easy to go down that road, because it's so easy to do. I mean, you're talking about a time where this type of activity is acceptable. Like, that shit happened. Most people on Earth probably don't even know that shit happened. Like, and the only reason I know is because I just watch a lot of shit. Like, I watch a lot of news outlets. I watch a lot of, podcasts and blogs and shit. Like, that's the only way I find out about shit, because unless you lived in Newark, you probably would have never known this. Like, and even though I think it was, like, on CNN or it was in the New York Times and shit, but people don't really read that kind of information. People don't really watch those kind of news shows, you know. And when I say people, I'm talking about, like, you know, regular Joes like myself and my community. We don't do a lot of research like that, so it's kind of oblivious to us. But I'm just imagining a 10-year-old kid being chased by police, bro. I can't get that shit out of my mind. And what's even worse, though, was the response. After the fact, I just need some police officers to be like, yo, we fucked up. We shouldn't have been chasing a kid. Like, take this card. Like, take this card and talk to my superior officer or something. Like, get something. Because, like, I mean, in the reality of things, the shit could have went, like, all the way bad. Like, they could have shot the kid. They could have killed him. And then, like, of course, we know that you can kill black people as a police officer, and then nothing happens. Because you're not gonna go to jail. So that shit could have went way worse. And in a climate like we have it right now, it's imperative. Like, it's beyond imperative that police try to find a way to make a connection with our community. Because if not, this shit is just going to get way worse. Way worse, though. And I didn't want to get all deep like that, but shit, that story killing me, man. That shit is crazy right there. So we ain't going to go no further into that. Don't forget, though, if you're on eblockradio.com right now, you can hit me up at 760-283-4647 and then hit that number one key. Tonight, man, we're talking about Donald Trump. I know a lot of people like to talk about Donald Trump or politics, but that's what we're on right now because it's a heavy political climate right now. It's about that time. You only got a couple months left before it's time to put that vote in. So all you knuckleheads who say y'all ain't going to vote, y'all better go ahead and do that quick plan. But, yeah, we definitely going to talk about Trump. And what I want to know, man, tonight, I want to know, do you think that Trump can really win black votes? All right, so that's what we want to check out today. We want to see how many black people will actually vote for Donald Trump. Now, the numbers are surprising, man. So I'm going to go through these numbers in a moment when we come back from the commercial break. So don't be surprised when we hear some of these numbers, and then you're going to start looking at some of the people that you talk to every day, wondering who the hell these people are who are going to vote for Donald Trump. We're going to find out, though. Don't forget, if you're on eblockradio.com, hit us up 760-283-4647. And hit that number one key. We go shoot to commercial break for a moment, man. We're going to start off with our number one supporter down in the ATL, Black Tie Photography. We'll be back in a couple minutes. That's your boy.
Witness the Black Tie Experience. Black Tie Photography, servicing all of Metro Atlanta area. My name is Cedric Pitts, your photographer. Check out our website at www.blacktiepictures.com or like our Facebook page, facebook.com/blacktiepictures. Let me capture your professionalism and class, and you will have the ultimate black tie experience.
Yo, 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 it's your boy, the Hood Howard Stern, Q Lewis, producer of the Livest Cloud Radio Show on the planet, straight from the E-Block Radio. Here to let you know that you can represent the radio show and your side of town with our very own t-shirt line, Pardon My East Side. You can get yours.
Hi, Hood Howard Stern. What's up with Pardon My West Side?
Oh, slow down, Miss Coco J. Of course, we got the West Side covered, too. So you can get Pardon My East Side or Pardon My West Side t-shirts. Only thing you got to do is go to the website, www.eblockradio.com, and get yours today. $20 for the fellas, $15 for the ladies. Don't forget to follow us on Instagram as well, Pardon My East Side.
The livest cloud radio show on the planet. E-Block Radio.
Yo, 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 we back in the building, man, after the short intermission, a little commercial break right there. I want to thank everybody for checking us out right now on eblockradio.com. Don't forget, if you want to comment today, you got to hit me up, 760-283-4647, and hit the number one key. Don't forget to hang out to the end tonight, man. We got my man Lonzo Starr, the musical guest tonight. We got his brand new single, Clark Kent. All right, so it's Lonzo Starr. So shout out to my man Lonzo Starr. We'll be playing this joint at the end of the night tonight, so make sure you stick around for that. Also, too, I want to give a shout out to my partners, all right, over at Blackout Radio, GMS Radio in the UK, Sky 99 FM in Trinidad, and of course, New Orleans TalkNetwork.com. All right, so make sure you check them out, too. Those are our partners. That means you can check out these rebroadcasts on all of those places, as well as www.eblockradio.com. All right, so we back in the building, man, so you're just now checking us out. You got to know what we're talking about tonight, all right? We're talking about Donald Trump, all right? So I want to know, can Donald Trump really win black votes? All right, so that's what we want to know right now. Don't forget, you can hit me up and voice your opinion. 760-283-4647, man. Hit up your boyhood Howard Stein, all right? So, look, this is going to be surprising to a lot of people because, first of all, it don't seem like nobody black would ever vote for Donald Trump, right? That's what you're thinking. At least that's what I was thinking, right? And that was actually the case at first, right? So back in the day, well, I guess back in the day, but maybe like early on in the campaign, the numbers got a lot surprising, though, right? So this is what I mean by that. Back in June, and this was only a couple months ago, all right, so back in June, it was around, let me take a look here and pull those numbers back up. Back in June, it was about 6, it was between 1 to 6%, right, of voters who supported Donald Trump were black, right? So we talk about 1 to 6%. It's not a large percentage. When you think about it, it's probably a few black people you know that could fall into that 1 to maybe 6%. So you think about that, and it kind of makes sense, right? But the most recent, well, first let me say this. In July, it started creeping, though, right? So in July, it was between 8 to 10%. Now, this factor all this shit, though. You know, in July, he was talking shit about, you know, he had already been talking shit about building walls and blocking Mexicans out. And so he was talking a lot of crazy shit. And the support from black people had actually been rising, though. That's a little strange to me. And who knows? Because who knows who's doing these polls? You know, who knows who's being manipulated? No, I'm not even sure. But in July, it kind of got between 8 to 10%. Now, in the most recent polls, though, now I really swear to God, I don't know how true this is. But in the most recent polls, though, it actually says that Donald Trump is receiving support from close to 20% in the black community. That sounds a little high to me. I really can't believe that. I'm trying to figure out 20%. I don't know 20 people that would vote for Donald Trump. I mean, first of all, the politics of politics, right? Just to use both of those words together, the politics of politics is something that's kind of, you know, it's kind of daunting. For black people anyway, right? Because it's kind of a lose-lose. It kind of doesn't matter in the grand scheme of things as far as presidencies, because if you got the right president in office, but then you got all the worst local people in your area, you know what I'm saying, doing all the jurisdiction, all the laws, all the lawmaking, then it don't really matter anyway because you don't have to benefit from it. But from this standpoint, I mean, I think most black people, at least myself, I can definitely say that this is a lesser of two evils type of thing, which most often is the case anyway in any political race. I mean, it's just kind of like the worst or the best scenario in two bad pods, though, because they both just, you know, however you want to look at it. Now, of course, Hillary Clinton is probably, you know, name recognition is probably on her side from our community because she does the most, I guess is the only way I can say it. She does the most in winning our votes. And perhaps it's authentic, you know, perhaps it's not. I mean, the reality of it is, though, is that no matter how much either party, the Democrats or Republicans, no matter how much they pray for our vote and say how much our vote is needed and talk about how many things are going to be implemented on our behalf, it all sounds good up until November, and then after November, we end up being in the same box. So it kind of doesn't matter in that aspect. But to truly feel like you made an educated vote for Donald Trump, it's something that I would need somebody to clarify for me. Because out of those 20%, if somebody randomly is listening right now on eblockradio.com and you plan to vote for Donald Trump, dog, hit me up right now, 760-283-4647, man, and hit that number one key and tell me why. I just want to know, like, because I've got to figure this out. And then a few days ago, you know, forgive me for my time interpretation, but a few days ago, you know, I had actually posted something on my Instagram and my Facebook that I had reposted from somewhere, I can't even remember, but it was, you know, it was Donald Trump talking about, you know, the black voters. Now, I guess, first of all, let me take a look at this. In the clip, he says basically, you know, just to kind of sum it up, I can't get it word for word, but just to kind of sum it up, it's like people in the black community, basically, black America, he said that, you know, you live in impoverished areas, schools are terrible, and what do you say, like over 50% of your youth are unemployed, so why not vote, you know, why not vote for you, right? All right, so let's take a look at that. So some of that is true. Now, all of us don't experience that. You know, all of us don't live in impoverished areas. All of us are not unemployed. You know, all of us didn't get education from a terrible school system, right? So, first of all, there are certain areas, even in white communities, that experience that same thing. But when you have a presidential candidate that's willing to put us all in that one bag and say a statement like that, how can you legitimately say that you support that kind of candidate, though? I guess that's what I'm curious of. I think what I don't understand is that's like reinforcement of the whole white supremacist orientation of America anyway. And that's what it feels like to me. So I don't see how you could actually say that you support something like that when although it is true for a percentage of us, we have all been put in the one bag as if we all one group and we all went to terrible schools, we all live in an impoverished neighborhood. That's not the case. I mean, those sectors of impoverished people and fucked up schools and high unemployment rates are sections in any community, not just ours. So, I definitely can't understand that, but he's desperately trying to get our vote. I mean, at the last minute, though. So, first of all, he ain't said shit about black people this whole time. But see, it's getting closer to November, so now he got to have about one or two votes and shit. Right, so you had all these months, all that time he was, you know, debating and doing all this shit. Now it's important. So, I mean, what's really our problem? Like, do we think Hillary Clinton is that bad? I mean, the government's fucked up regardless. Like, I mean, if you put only person that can say the White House now is Jesus or Allah, you know, whatever, whoever you worship, you know what I'm saying? But yeah, that's the only person that can save us right now, man. But look, if you're out there right now, even if you ain't supporting Trump, I just want to hear what you got to say about that. Can Trump really win black votes, man? Hit me up, 760-283-4647. Hit that number one key, man. We're going to go to the phone lines real quick. I got Coco J on the line right now, 313-459. You on live straight from the E-Block. How about your boy?
Hey, what's going on, Hood Old Thing?
What up, Don?
Down old Trump. Down old Trump. Down old Trump.
Yeah, right. Yeah, okay.
I'm just all jokes aside. No Donald Trump. No, not for me anyway.
Okay,
but,
I was about to say.
No, not going to go there.
Okay.
But can Trump get black voters, you're asking, right?
Yeah, yeah. Can,
okay.
Do you think that's right? I mean, obviously right now it's kind of showing that he is. But
yeah.
But how? Like, I don't even know how that shit is possible.
You know what? If we have more Stacey Dashes out there, then of course. So,
Stacey Dash. I was going to try to lay off of her.
Yeah, but I'm just saying, that's just is an example. So we have, it's obvious that we have, it's more than one Stacey Dash out there. So, I mean, people think that way, you know, when he's talking, and they can be black or white, it don't even matter. But some people is foolish enough to go for it, you know. So,
right.
Unfortunately, with the black, in the black community, that he's definitely getting black votes. And,
right.
I mean, it's like, it can be somebody of African-American that's against African-American as well. Because we definitely have some of those kinds that against their own race. So they, and then politics, period, to me, is money. Donald Trump is money. He's a businessman. So he's going to put it in a way to where he's putting it in a way to where the world is business, which it is. So it is. But at the same time, who wants Donald Trump running? Donald Trump is, my opinion, I don't like Donald Trump. He's very ignorant to me.
If he's not, he's doing a bad job of not proving it.
Right. But no, he's been ignorant before he even started running for Donald Trump. I never did like Donald Trump. Never, ever did like him. But as far as with the black community, him getting the votes, I'm sure that he is, because some black folks like what he's saying, just like some of the other people that's Caucasian people is liking what he's saying. And like you just said, he just started really trying to get black folks.
Because one is getting closer, and that's where
a lot of the votes come from. I'm not gonna say I don't know what the percentage is, but once we get out there and vote like we should vote, then yeah.
Right.
So, unfortunately, it's people out there in the black community that's voting for him. But shame. That's all I can say.
Right. For real, man. That's crazy.
Yeah.
All right. Thanks for your comment, though. I didn't think you was going to say nothing at all.
I wasn't. You already know I don't talk politics. I don't like politics. I know. So I'm just showing some love. I just figured I'd just chime in for a minute.
For sure. That's what's up.
Yeah. All right. Well, I'll talk to you later.
All right. For sure. Thanks for your call, guys.
All right.
For sure. Yeah, for sure. So that was the wifey on the line right there, Coco J. Don't forget, man, you can check out me and Coco J tomorrow night, all right, at 6 p.m. Eastern Standard Time on He Say, She Say, all right, at www.eblockradio.com. So make sure you check out our show tomorrow. But I know my baby don't like politics. I had even asked her earlier because I knew that Money wasn't going to make it to the studio today. So I asked her, like, you know, you want to sit in? And she's like, nah, I don't do no politics. So I'm actually surprised she said something. So I'm gracious that she was able to grace the microphone, but, you know, with some insight there. So make sure, again, you check us out tomorrow night, 6 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, He Say, She Say. But, so give me this last minute, like, you know, I call it a last-ditch effort. You know, we're the second option. Like, nobody checking for black people at first. I mean, from Donald Trump's side, you know, nobody checking for us at first. So, like, what's all the rush now? I mean, he got Omarosa on his team now, like some kind of black advocate or something. I guess he's supposed to get all the black votes. I guess he must don't know that black people don't fuck with Omarosa anyway. Like, yeah, black people don't fuck with Omarosa, so he probably should have got somebody else. Like, nobody checking for Omarosa. I don't know if that's really going to get her, you know, no black votes. But, I mean, just looking at the, and I can't even say policies, because he hasn't given no real explanation of what he's going to do as a president. He hasn't given any real clarity as what any plans are, what nothing. Like, nothing is in stone. All you know is he's an arrogant asshole. Like, it's all you know. But at the end of the day, possibly, you know, this is just me making assumptions, possibly the reason why people may support him is because he is what America is. Like, there's no, like, you say he's an asshole, you say he don't know this, he don't like Mexicans, he don't like Muslims, he say outlandish shit. But at the end of the day, I think maybe that's what turned people on to him, though. The fact that he don't give a fuck. You know, people actually like that. Like, people like that he don't give a fuck. Like, at the end of the day, they don't care that he seems retarded. It's like, he just don't give a fuck. If you get somebody up there who can just say anything, it makes them feel empowered that you got somebody in office that would just say anything that's on his mind. But the bad thing, though, is that would never work in our favor, though. Just to give you a broad scope of things, like, because he's a businessman, right? So just to give you a broad scope of things, his his international presence is not, you know, it's not really there. Like, you know what I'm saying? It doesn't really exist. So let's think about some things. You've got black people in America who can barely, and I had a conversation like this like last week or week before with somebody who called in, but you got black people in America who can barely get a small business loan, right? So if you got companies who are, you know, smaller in nature and may have some dealings internationally, but you have a president who fuck up those international ties, then that small business loses money, and then that small business is not able to contribute to the community, so that community can't produce any business owners of its own. So that's a trickle-down effect. So you thought it was tough to get a business loan now. Wait till they fuck up international trade. You know what I'm saying? Because you put Donald Trump in there, dog, some shit is going to go bad. He didn't talk too much shit about Muslims and shit like that when knowing that America killing motherfuckers for oil and other shit in the Middle Eastern areas. So America going around slaughtering motherfuckers, killing people, taking over their villages and shit and supposedly putting them into a democracy, which just means that we go take all your resources and then make you need something from us. That's all that means. If you think that sounds familiar, yes, that sounds like slavery. They go take you, use you for what you got, and then make you dependent on them. Like, yeah, that's the concept. So in case you didn't know, you live in a place where that was the concept from the beginning. Like, that shit ain't changed. Like, the system ain't broke. That's what the fuck it was supposed to do. It's supposed to strip you of everything and then make you become dependent on it. So that's exactly what it's supposed to do. So it's working. It's working tremendously. So then you want to put in a president who has no candor. And that just means he can't – that's like the drunk uncle. Like, you just want him to stay the fuck in the room when you got company. Like, don't let drunk uncle out the back. Because he just going to fuck something up. He going to say something stupid. Everybody going to get mad and leave and shit. That's the same kind of concept we're dealing with right now. So there's no way that I can even fathom why black people go to the polls in November and vote for Donald Trump. So I guess the question is, can Trump really win black votes? I say that he can win votes. I don't think he can win enough to actually make a difference and make a push for the White House. I don't think so. But there are some people who just believe in just being an asshole. Like, they think there's some kind of power in his ability to say any fucking thing and just roll with it. But that's the thing, though. That's what America's been doing the whole time. Talking shit, kicking ass and taking names, right? And no accountability for nothing, right? I mean, that's what America is. So when you get Donald Trump, what you really are getting is America, right? So we got a couple minutes left, man. If you're on eblockradio.com, you can hit me up, 760-283-4647. Hit that number one key, man. Look like we got GG on the line. Is that GG on the line? 313-208. You're on live, straight from the e-block. How about your boy?
I want to know, straight from the e-block. Yeah, I'm like, Jose, I don't really have any thoughts in regards to Donald Trump either. not too much on politics, but your question is about him winning the black vote and why he's doing it now at the end of his campaign.
Yeah.
And my thoughts about that is just, I feel like that's a strategy as well, because people who weren't smart enough to actually become educated on either candidate won't necessarily make an informed decision about who they should actually really vote for. It's more like that last impression. So they may make a spontaneous decision just based off the last things that they've heard, because they haven't been following the campaign. They haven't done time to research the candidates. They haven't done time to research history, period.
Yeah, so
it's like that movie, that Will Smith movie, Focus, where he was gambling with people's minds, where he had been implanting things in their head, you know what I'm saying?
That's what I'm saying,
to get, you know, people to vote, you know, I'm saying, for it to work in his favor. So, yeah, let me, you know, shoot a little couple things out there that's geared toward the black community to make them, you know, give that last impression and say, okay, well, maybe, you know, he is the man for the job or whatever. But I mean, that's only for the people who don't really know, you know, the history behind voting, the history behind, you know, black, you know, African-American history, however you want to put it. So I think that's just another business strategy. Because at the end of the day, he is a businessman, but if people want to talk about, you know, America and the principles and things that we're supposed to stand on, we're not, even though it's ran as a business, you still want somebody who's in there for the people, not necessarily the business, you know what I'm saying? So
I'm sure
he may, I don't know. I want to say he might be useful in another area, but I doubt it. I don't even want to give him that much credit because he just comes off as a complete fucking asshole. He was my friend. But it's a right way and a wrong way to do everything at the end of the day. So if, in fact, he does have some type of intelligence, he has a hell of a way of showing it. And if somebody can fall for that, then they'll fall for anything.
For sure.
Yeah,
hey, thanks for your call, though, babe.
Yeah, meanwhile, on the plantation, I'll be voting.
I'll see, man. For sure. All right, thanks for your call, though.
All right, then.
Yeah, for sure. So, yeah, that's exactly what I was saying, though. It's just like, I mean, I think we all three in agreement on that. So, same thing Coco J was saying. I think for the most part, people don't really like talking about politics, but they don't really. Like, it's no way that they can go for Donald Trump. But like Gigi said just then, is that it could be a strategy, like just trying to get those last second voters, kind of like last second shoppers, you know what I'm saying? Like you like impulse buying, you know. So you got everybody in the black community saying, "Hey, shit, you better vote. Like, get off your ass and vote. Go vote." So last minute, you're like, "Fuck, I'm gonna go vote. Shit, I'm just gonna vote for whoever." You know, that kind of thing. So possibly it was a strategy from the beginning not to include us and then kind of throw us in at the end. It could have been a strategy, which would actually make him smarter than he seems. Yeah, so I don't even want to give him that much credit. But anyway, man, so we had a good conversation today, man. I held it down. My man bought money out doing his thing, you know what I'm saying? So couldn't make it to the studio, so I held it down for him. We had a good, healthy conversation about Donald Trump hopefully not winning any more black votes. But we're going to have to wrap it up now. But make sure you hang out to the end of the show, though, because we're getting ready to play Lonzo Starr. All right, so his new single, Clark Kent. All right, in case you don't know who Clark Kent is, man, Clark Kent is Superman before he takes his glasses off. You feel me? That's Superman before he takes his glasses off. That's who Clark Kent is, right? So shout out to my man Lonzo Starr getting ready to do his thing in a moment. I want to thank everybody who checked us out tonight on eBotRadio.com. Everybody who checked this out and called in and was scared to comment, it's okay. Sorry, I know I'm still in love. Y'all was just scared to talk politics, and that's okay. Ain't no thing, man. Another shout-out to my partners, Blackout Radio, GMS Radio in the UK, Sky 99 FM in Trinidad, and New Orleans TalkNetwork.com. All right, so shout-out to all our partners and our supporters. But until next week, man, we up out of here, about to end the show with my man Lonzo Starr, Clark Kent. We up out of here, man. Peace. It's your boy, Hood Howard Stern, Q Lewis, holding it down from the D to the other D in the Rocky Mountains, man. We up out of here. Peace.
Baby, you must be an angel. When the light hits you just right, one could mistake you for a star. That is exactly what you are.
I wonder if she noticed me, or even if she know it's me. She said I'm like them other guys, but she's too blind to see through my disguise. And it's funny how the time goes. If I was the man that you needed, you would never know. And when I walk into a room, she don't look twice, except she's looking at them niggas that don't treat her right. Lex Lucas, Nightmares, Freddy Krueger, the type of niggas that pack heat and carry Rugers. The type of niggas that I gotta see the world from. The type of niggas that I gotta see my girl from. But what's the point if she don't listen? Why should I care from the one that she ain't missing? But it's funny how your time spent. While you looking for Superman, I be your Clark Kent.
Then the night takes over. You are nowhere to be found.
While you looking for Superman, I be your Clark Kent.
Then the night takes over. You are nowhere to be found.
Da-da-da, da-da-da, da-da-da-da.
Your face in broken pieces. Don't you look down.
The livest cloud radio show on the planet, E-Block Radio.